Who don't you like? Because I even heard you defended Michael Jackson.
Well, I did. I defended. I heard your show yesterday, and it was sort of funny and sad at the same time.
It is sad, but
see, I knew Michael at his peak.
He lives in one of your buildings?
He lives in Trump Tower. He has an apartment.
And he also was around when he was married to Lisa Marie. You were sort of witness to that whole thing.
I was a part of it because he met Lisa Marie at Mar-a-Lago.
That's right.
In Palm Beach, and he fell in love.
Come on.
I'm telling you, Howard.
What are you talking about?
Howard.
Come here. Look at me.
It was love. I'm
this
telling
is Howard
you,
you're talking about.
Listen, first of all, it was a little bit of a different Michael.
Okay.
Michael Jackson, 15 years ago, was the greatest superstar since Elvis. He was the greatest.
He had his day. He had his day.
He had his day, and he blew it. And, you know, some plastic surgeon blew it for him, okay? I mean, frankly, if he didn't have... You know, it started with the Pepsi Cola, with the bomb that landed on his head and screwed him up, and it went on. And, you know, Michael, it's a very tragic thing. Michael Jackson's a very smart, very good guy who truly has changed a lot. And
but wait a second, what do you think? Do you think the guy, I mean, sleeping with kids in that room, come on, what's up with that? You know.
Well, I know
we spend all day training chicks in our
room.
I defended him, and then the announcer asked me, well, would you allow your son, Eric, to spend some time? I said, are you crazy? He
goes, yeah, you would.
Which was not a good defense, I think. I think I blew.
Yeah, but you wouldn't let your son spend any time in some adult guy's bedroom anyway,
well,
no matter who the guy is.
My sons were really cute, beautiful little kids with white hair and gorgeous little kids when they were little. And they're still beautiful, but now they're big guys.
Answer me this.
Eric is 6'6". I'll never forget, 10 years ago, Eric was like 7, and Michael was at Mar-a-Lago.
Uh-oh.
And he said, Trump, your son is very beautiful.
Oh, no.
I must take him to Neverland.
Get out of here.
Now, I thought this was the nicest thing. I said, isn't this nice? He's the nicest guy. He wants to take my son to Neverland. Then I said, what is Neverland?
Where is Neverland? You're never going to see him again.
What does that mean?
He'd call and say, where is Eric? And Eric, you know, went to school and stuff, and I just couldn't do it.
You see how you can get sucked in,
though?
And
now I'm very happy about it.
But do you see how you can get sucked in?
You would have done it.
Well, no, but he probably would have been fine with my son. I don't think he was going to do it.
See, that's ballsy.
Are you out of your mind?